Bokertov, or as we just found out that it's actually pronounced, Bukar Tub. Okay? And that's just from this morning. My husband and I, we are always talking scripture. We're always talking about Paleo Hebrew, Yahudi, and Greek and Latin and all these different translations, and we're always researching this stuff, and it is awesome. So I always like, okay, let me just start over. I have been telling my husband for at least 2 months, if not longer, I need to make videos. I need to make videos. I want to make videos. I want to put videos on my YouTube. I want to talk on these videos about the stuff that we talk about and like share it with everybody else because it's so freaking awesome. And I can't, like, my brain starts melting because I'm like, what? And that just happened today. My husband just made a regular post that was him sharing a memory from several years ago, probably like 2014. And it wasn't even very long. It was like one sentence. And I just had this moment. I don't like the term my mind was blown because if you take that literally, it's not a good thing. But I think everybody knows what I mean when I say, like, it just blew my mind. I'm just sitting here like, what? And it was such a strong feeling that I was like, okay, you know what? I can't take it anymore. I'm going to set up my webcam. I'm going to set up the microphone. I can't. This is too crazy. So I made a Facebook post about it, but okay. Let me see. All he said was Shamayim. It's two words into one. The Shamayim is Hebrew and it means heaven. Or at least that's what everybody always says. The Shamayim means heaven, okay? But he broke it down into the two words put together. Shah means salvation and Mayim means water. Salvation water. The word for heaven is salvation water. And I was just sitting there like, whoa. Oh my gosh. Okay. It made me realize that all the water that exists on earth right now was once in the Shemayim with Yahuwah, and he put it down here. He separated the waters. We've tampered with it so bad it's not even living like it is up there, and yet we still have living water. That's water. We take it for granted, and yet we use it every single day, over and over and over and over and over and over. Gallons and gallons and gallons each person is using every single day, and we take it for granted. And you know, we always see like people that have to travel for like several miles carrying water on their head in an old gas can, just so they can cook and clean and stay alive every single day, you know. And we feel so blessed, or we should, for having access to water like that in our homes, where you just turn the faucet on, there's fresh, clean, cold water, and you turn the other faucet and it's hot. Since moving into this church and renovating it, man, it's been a bumpy ride. It sounds exciting, and it really has been an adventure. But more than that, it's been a learning experience, because this was the first time in my life I had to really tough it out. And toughing it out in America isn't even really anything compared to toughing it out in like a third world country or a place where it's really, really almost uninhabitable with like terrible sanitation, and you get the idea. But yet toughing it out here, I found it was like, it was psychologically difficult, and I realized just how freaking spoiled I actually am. We did not have any water hookups when we first moved here. No bathroom. We were having to go to a hotel and use the shower there once a week. I mean, it was rough, okay? We were roughhousing it. We had to use a bucket for a toilet. And then we got septic. We got water. We still have water, but we don't have a water heater just yet. And we're getting things slowly as time goes on. But just getting water and just getting the septic and having a toilet and a sink, I don't think I can. I hope I don't ever take those for granted ever again. Lesson learned. And I didn't even have to go without them for very long, and it was really testing me psychologically. And I made it, and now I'm just so grateful when I turn on the sink and water comes out. And it's not muddy, it's not rusty, it's not, well, I'm pretty sure we all know that a lot of our water has been tampered with, but overall, it's good water compared to many, many, many other places around the world. So, that being said, even in the, as much as we complain and we don't like what they're doing to our water, it's still incredible. And everybody's experienced when you've had a really long day and you're hot, you're sweaty, it's summertime, you're dehydrated, and you just get that glass of water that's so cool and refreshing. It's got sweat on the outside of the glass, and you just start chugging it, and it's so refreshing and vitalizing, and you're like, oh, I needed that so bad. Okay, just imagine that feeling. If we're capable of experiencing that feeling here on Earth with our water being tampered with and impure, and yet we can still feel that vitality in it, just imagine how pure and amazing the water in the Shemayim really is. The waters that are surrounding Yahuwah and his throne. This is that, that just was like, and then even more than that, the water from the Shemayim was split and some of it was down here. And then, of course, Noah's flood, there was floodgates in the heavens that opened, and there was also the flood water from the deep came up. Okay, so that's the water that we're currently drinking, and it circulates inside of our body. Okay, the water is literally swimming around in your brain right now, and there are electrical synapses crossing different places in your brain just so you can listen to what I'm saying and see the video so that your eyes can filter it, so that your ears can filter it, and there's blood pumping. And it has to have the oxygen from the water and the oxygen from the air that you breathe. There's water molecules in the air, and our body has to filter that and all this. I mean, it's incredible. We can't exist without this substance. And its actual name is Shemayim, salvation water. And that's where all of water, all H2O, originated from. It's living. It's a lot. I don't want to say the word alive, but it's living. Nobody should at all think that they don't have the Creator dwelling inside them. We are way more powerful than we've been led to believe. Way more. That is crazy. Well, it's actually not crazy. It's the truth. But it sounds crazy when you don't know these things and you go your whole life not knowing them. So anyway, I just thought I would share that with everybody. I'm gonna go water my plants with water that is a diluted version of the salvation waters in the Shemayim, and my plants are gonna love it. And the water that actually drips from the clouds, rainwater, is always the best for plants. And we've been very, very blessed. We've been getting the perfect amount of rain. It's not flooding here, but yet everything is lush and green and vibrant. And I'm just so thankful. I'm so thankful, and I'm so thankful that I have a garden, and I'm producing fruits and vegetables and even nuts and berries. And this is also an answered prayer. For years, I was praying to Yahuwah, please let me live off of your provision, not the government, not food stamps, not grocery stores, not money buying food. I want to be able to plant seeds in the ground and care for them. And you, Creator, are sparking these plants with vitality and sending them up to produce. You're working your part of the end, with the cellular structure, telling the plant's DNA to grow and produce fruit and seeds so that I can eat. And then it goes into my body and it's healing and it's healthy, because Genesis, and of course, Leviticus, we have the Creator telling us what is good for our body, and He created it, so He knows better than anyone else what our bodies were designed for and what energy from the plants and the food, what's going to actually put living vitality back into our cell structure. Okay, I'm just getting too far out there. I'm sorry. But I hope everybody has a great day, Boker Tov, and wrap your head around that one. You have living water that once existed in the Shemayim, in the throne of, around the throne of Yahuwah. It's flowing in your brain. It's flowing in your bloodstream and your body right now. It's even in your mouth and your saliva, and you drink it every day. You drink a diluted version of it, and yet it's refreshing, it's vitalizing, and it keeps you living right now. It keeps you living. You have a part of the Creator inside of you at all times. Your body is made of what? 75-80% of it? All right. Thanks for watching.